Do you feel as if adults in the community, even including us, don't really understand what your lives are like?
Yeah.
Why or why not?
Yes.
Why?
Like bullying, like my grand, like that never happened whenever she was little. It happens more now.
Like more
like people getting beat up.
More people. Like in my school, this year alone, there was at least 4 fights in 1 month, and one was horrible. One kid got flown to Pittsburgh Hospital because this one kid came up behind him, punched him, and stomped on his face with cleats on and broke his eye socket. And yet, all that happened was they looked into it and they said that the kid who got his eye socket broke was doing stuff to the kid who broke his eye socket, so the kid didn't get in trouble.
What do you mean? So if was talking about your dad, Diavion, you wouldn't beat up the girl that did it?
I sure would.
All right then.
Yeah, but the thing is...
Why would you?
Because I'm not about to let somebody talk about my family. I'm not with that. I would beat up anybody.
It's not right, but you shouldn't go and...
That's what I mean by acting tough.
Yeah, you shouldn't go take it into your own hands and then hurt, seriously injure the person, and then get away with it.
I feel like
they wouldn't have been seriously injured if their mouth was shut. They wouldn't have said nothing. Then that would have happened. Lenny don't beat people up for no reason. He has reasons.
Well,
so ultimately then, is violence okay?
No, violence.
It's not that violence is okay. It's just the fact that they shouldn't have said nothing.
Because you do tell them, like, you get beat up. Yeah, you'll get beat up with it.
Then you have to fight
even more. Doesn't do anything. Like, has, like, I don't know, their logos, like, don't get bullied or something.
Trojans don't bully Trojans.
Yeah, and like, that doesn't make
that
sense.
That most definitely happens. People get bullied at Johnstown.
Oh, yeah, there was like this one security guard, his name's Mark. He was right there about a fight, and I'm sitting there, and it's like a 2-on-2 fight, and they're like just beating each other. They're just beating each other senseless, and there's nobody doing nothing. It took about like 20 minutes for someone to stop the fight.
Security guards, they be watching fighting. Too scared to get in the fight.
Like my cousins go to Johnstown, and his one friend he started getting beat up, and the security guard tased him instead of the kid. He started
trying so hard to seem respectful to us as teens that they forget that they're security guards, and they just don't, like, they do their jobs, just not all the time, and sometimes it's just not right, you know. Moved here, there was a whole situation with this guy in one of my classes. But for the longest time, for the whole year, I was just picked on. And I told my mom, and so he told the principal, and the principal was like, because he, like, when we were in gym, he would, like, throw balls at me, at my face, like, to hurt me. So the principal was like, oh, he's probably just being a boy, you know. And that's a way to tell you that they like you. And so he didn't do anything about it. No one did anything about it. So I'm being picked on by this guy and his friends, and then like a group of girls, and it's hard. So I can't tell the principal again, because he's just gonna tell me that that he likes me. And so I just have to sit in that.
Bullying is something that doesn't need to be done. It's like, it just makes you look pathetic. Like, you stoop down to that level to make yourself feel good.
Like both of the girls said about, you know, there's drugs and there's bullying. They do this because, well, people bully other people because, you know, the main reason that they feel bad about themselves, or they just want to see other people feel bad. And if they saw something better in other people, if they saw something better in themselves, then they wouldn't do drugs, they wouldn't bully other people. It'd be a lot about all the people that love me, all the people that I love, like my mom, my sister, my brothers. I think that if I were to, you know, end my life, that all these people would miss me. Like, I would affect them so much more than they've ever affected me, you know? Like, I would just, like, my baby brother would grow up without a big sister. And without one of his big sisters. And my mom would have to wait 3 more years to see someone drive a car or go to college, or, you know? And so I think about all the milestones that I would make and how that would affect the people that I love.